The Health Ministry's Permanent Secretary, Dr. Diana Atwine, today appeared before Parliament's Public Accounts Committee. She was called to respond to queries cited in the Auditor General's report for the financial year ended June 2022 regarding the plight of medical interns.
We have staffing gaps in the medical field, right? And you and I know that that gap is usually reduced by the services of the interns. And last time we had, you were saying that some parents who are able to pay for their children will be getting some money and paying for their children's internship. Is that a position of the ministry?
The question about payment of interns, I think, is not with Minister of Health. Minister of Health has put up their case. It is us, the Speaker, the Parliament of Uganda, to stand firm and call the Minister of Finance to order.
MPs pointed to the absence of a clear policy on training of medical interns as a source of the endless impasse. Medics have been demonstrating for over 3 months now over delayed deployment.
Internship policy, if they have, do they have an internship policy? Because what is internship? If internship is a part of training, then how can you fail to train your people? Because without going under internship, it's like someone doing education and you don't do teaching practice.
The Law Council has a role in determining even the numbers that access legal education. I want to know the role of the Ministry of Health.
In her response, Atwine told the committee that a policy to address issues around the plight of medical interns is in its final stages. She disclosed that the Ministry of Health is proposing a limit on the pre-medical interns deployed to different training facilities every year based on the absorption capacity.
What the private universities and public universities are graduating every year, the numbers are way, way, way above the provisions in the budget for internship support.
Atwine told MPs that their proposal is not alien because it's the practice in several other countries. This means deployment for internship will depend on availability of placements in training hospitals if the policy under draft is approved by Cabinet.
They don't limit the numbers of trainees, but they limit the number at the university, but they don't at training at Ministry of Health. They limit the number they can take and train for that period, meaning it is not automatic that when you finish you must all be taken into training center to do internship.
Meanwhile, the Public Accounts Committee has directed officials from the Ministry of Health to return the former Executive Director of Mulago National Referral Hospital, Dr. Biarugaba Baterena, to work. This after they failed to prosecute him for a year now. Biarugaba was interdicted last year over corruption.
You don't tarnish such a man's name because the arrest and interdiction were all public. And remember we interfaced with him here. With your participation, we were able to get some information from him. But then the thing goes quiet.
The investigations, Health Monitoring Unit and police and DPP, we don't know how far they've gone. So for us, on our side, we do what we are supposed to do.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.